Project economy tonight with new businesses popping up all over Papillion. So why is that city able to buck the trend with so many others struggling? KATV News Watch 7's Melissa Fry is live with a story you're seeing new at 10. Melissa?
Rob, Papillion Mayor David Black tells me the city's seen 14 businesses open in just the last 6 months. Tonight, some small business owners tell me they put nearly their whole life savings into a chance on chocolate.
Cutting out of the economic slump one slice at a time, more than a dozen times in the last 6 months. Papillion's Mayor David Black says the growing city is still attracting small shops.
So why are individuals putting their own livelihood and their own money on the line to open a business that in a lot of cases needs people to use their discretionary income to spend the money? But yet it's happening over and over and over and over.
Take it from the family that sells truffles.
It's scary for any new business owner, startup small business owner, to put any of their money into it. And yes, we did put quite a bit of it. But
Susie and Chad Bonnet fell in love with Belgian chocolate when Chad was stationed overseas. Right before Christmas, they opened a Chocolatierie Stoms franchise in Papillion.
Everything that we saw said that this is something that people buy when times are bad and they buy when times are good.
The Bonnets say the toughest part, trying for a loan. They say several banks turned them down, but they opened anyways. And every day, they're taking on new ideas.
This is actually the first time I've made brownie dough.
And they're working with old ones.
All of the gelato equipment was bought used. Mm-hmm. Everything out here, the seating, and none of that's new.
Belief in a product and belief in the buyers, seen here at Jersey's Bar and Grill, at the coffee stop in downtown Papio, and even here where Lawler's expanded.
You look back in history of the country, whether it's recession or depression, who pulls it out? Small business, being optimistic.
Now other businesses include a bike shop, two cookie stores, a tuck shop, and a bridal gallery. Reporting live, Melissa Fry, KETV News Watch 7.